स्क्रीन शेयर हुआ? हेलो।
यस सर। सर
हाँ, जस्ट जस्ट वेट करो वेट करो। नेक्स्ट है पॉपुलेशन इन्वर्सन के बाद नेक्स्ट है मेरा आइंस्टाइन्स कोएफिशिएंट। आइंस्टाइन्स कोएफिशिएंट ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। आइंस्टाइन्स कोएफिशिएंट इसको ध्यान से समझोगे, पढ़ना भी है इसको, समझना भी है। आइंस्टाइन्स कोएफिशिएंट बिफोर, हाँ, फर्स्ट क्लास मींस बिफोर दिस पीरियड आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दैट इफ वी आर टेकिंग ए कंटेनर एंड दिस कंटेनर वी आर प्लेसिंग सम ऑफ द एटम्स एंड एंड दिस कंटेनर इज हीटेड विथ अ टेम्परेचर टी, सो इन दैट केस द एटम्स आर moves in all direction. So after that all these three process, absorption, spontaneous and stimulated emission process will take place. So in thermal equilibrium the rate of upward transition, look here, in for absorption process, if the atom moves from here, suppose lower energy level is E1 and this energy upper energy level is E2. So if in thermal equilibrium the rate of upward transition means when the atoms move from energy level lower energy level E1 to upper energy level E2 must be equal to the rate of downward transition means when the atoms moves from upper energy level to lower energy level, that is downward transition process. If an atom can jump from upper energy level, here upper energy level E2, suppose here I have written already E2, if the atom jumps from E2 energy level to E1 energy level, that is lower energy level E1, so according to thermal equilibrium the rate of upward transition must be equal to rate of downward transition. If in energy level lower energy level E1 there are N1 atoms per unit volume with energy E1 in this container or ensemble, then absorption rate, transition rate from E1 to E2 is, here I have written N1 U mu V12. If there are, again I will repeat this line, if there are N1 atoms per unit volume with energy E1 in the ensemble, here this ensemble, then absorption transition rate from E1 to E2 is N1 U mu and V12. This in this equation 1, N1 be the number of atoms, this is the energy density, and V12 is referred to is a constant. V12 is taken because for this absorption process atom moves from energy level E1 to energy level E2. When the atoms starts moving from energy level E1, so first we can write E1 1 1. After that, when it reaches to energy level 2, that in that case we can write energy level 2. 1 indicates energy level 1 and 2 indicates energy level 2. So in that so it can be written as, for absorption process, dN1 by dt absorption, AB means absorption, is equal to V12 U mu energy density, N1 be the number of atoms present in this energy level E1. So this is equation one. Similarly, if there are n2 number of atoms per unit volume, if there are n2 number of atoms here in upper energy level, if there are n2 number of atoms per unit volume with energy here given as E2 in the ensemble, then stimulated emission will take place, means stimulated transition rate from E2 to E1 is here N2 U mu B20. Now this N22 be the number of atoms in the upper energy level. This is the energy, just a minute. Wait, Kanaiya Mishra, Rohit Rajivar. Okay. Now this N2 be the number of atoms, present in the upper energy level. Here energy, this part is known as energy state. And B21 means B21 is constant. It can be constant, taken as a constant. B21 means if an atom jumps from a second energy level, upper energy level, means E2 level, energy level to E1 energy level. So first, we can say that it means the atoms are present in this upper energy level 2. After that time, after time t, this atom reaches to the energy level 1. So it can be written as B21. B21. 21 to be the starting position of atoms present in that level, upper energy level, one in the ground state energy level, lower energy level. So if atom jumps from upper energy level to lower energy level, in that case we can write B21. This is the equation two. We can take this equation is taken two. Now next step is spontaneous emission. So in that case, atoms are also moves from upward direction to downward direction, upward energy level to downward energy level. So the spontaneous transition rate from E2 to E1 is N2. Here N2, this is N2, A21. N2 be the number of atoms present in the upper energy level, and A2, A21 be the is a constant. A21 is a constant here. Yeah, this part, equation three. dN2 divided by dt spontaneous is equal to N2 A20. This is equation three. A21 be a is a constant. Here I have taken 21. It means the atoms are present at initial stage in the energy level 2, and after t time it reaches to the ground energy state 1. So in that, so that's why I have taken 21 here. Here a what is changed, in place of B we can write A21, because here I have already written B21. So both the equations are same, both the terms are same in these two equations. That's why I have written for equation 2 D21, and for equation 3 it can be taken as A21. Hence, according to this diagram, according to this diagram, we can say that absorption process must be equal to the sum of spontaneous as well as stimulated emission. Means in absorption process, the atoms move from downward direction to upward direction, lower energy level to upper energy level. But for both these spontaneous emission and stimulated emission, the atoms moves from upper energy level to lower energy level. So according to this diagram, we can say that absorption process must be equal to sum of the sum of adding of both these emission process, spontaneous as well as stimulated emission. We can write here B12 is equal to energy density B12. Equation one is for absorption process. D1 by dt absorption. Here I have written already absorption. Absorption is equal to this part. Equation one. So equation one can be written in the left direction is equal to according to statement. Absorption process must be equal to sum of these two emission process. So value of stimulated emission is given in equation two, means B21 energy density u mu N2 plus sum means plus adding of equation two and three, means the value of spontaneous emission at time t is in equation three. So equation two and equation three will be added. Now after solving this equation, हाँ मनीष बोलो
सर, इक्वेशन थ्री और बता दीजिए. इक्वेशन थ्री सर,
इक्वेशन थ्री. नाउ इफ एन एटम जंप फ्रॉम अपर एनर्जी लेवल टू लोअर एनर्जी लेवल्स, E2 एनर्जी लेवल टू E1 एनर्जी लेवल, the spontaneous transition rate is equal to N2 A21 and is independent of the energy density. So in that case, here we cannot write energy density u mu. According to this diagram, we can say that if an atom, that spontaneous transition rate from E2 to E1, here E2, upper energy level is E2, E2 to E1, is N2A21 and it is independent of the energy density. That's why we can here we cannot write energy density u mu. A21, I have written A21 because atoms jump from energy level 2, means at initial stage the atoms is placed at the energy level 2, and after time t it reaches, after time t, here I have written t, after time t is reached to the lower energy level 1. That's why you can write dN2 by dt spontaneous is equal to N2A21, and this spontaneous emission is independent of the energy density. So in that case we cannot write here energy density and u mu. After getting all these three equations, 1, 2, 3, according to this diagram, we can say that absorption process is taken from lower direction to upper direction, and spontaneous and emission, both the process are taking from upper direction to lower direction. So according to this diagram, we can say that absorption process is equal to sum of the spontaneous as well as stimulated emission. Now, the value of absorption process is written here, B12 energy density N1 coming from equation 1 is equal to, the value of 2 is B21 energy density u mu N2 plus the value of spontaneous emission is given in equation 3, that is N2 N21. So here B12 energy density u mu N1 minus this part is going towards left, B21 energy density u mu N2 is equal to N2 A20. Now, after solving this equation, means when we take energy density as a common, the rest part is energy density into rest part is B12 here N1 minus, in the, for this part B21 B21 N2 is equal to N2 A21. Or we can write energy density U mu is equal to N2 divided by A21, means the value of right hand side divided by N1 B12 minus N2 B20. We are getting equation 4. And the value of energy density is given in this equation 4. Now, according to the statement of population inversion, we know that the number of, for laser action, higher population is required in the upper energy level. So here, upper energy level is E2, and the number of atoms present in E2 energy level is N2. We are already talking about energy level E1 and N2, and number of atoms are present in both energy level. N1 be the number of atoms present in lower energy level E1, and N2 be the number of atoms present in E2 energy level. So, according to population inversion, for laser action, higher population is required in the upper energy level. So, in this figure, N2 be the number of atoms present in the upper energy level E2. So equation 4, dividing N2 and N1 by N2 in equation 4, dividing N2 and N1 by all N2 and all N1 by N2, because N2 be the number of atoms, higher number of atoms present in the upper energy level. So this part, energy density is equal to here N2 divided by this N2 into A21 divided by N1 divided by here N2 into B12 minus N2 by N2 into this B21. So here N2 by N2 will be cancelled, and the rest part is energy density U mu is equal to, I have not written rest part in this page because there is no space in this page. So rest part is energy density is equal to A21 divided by N1 divided by this N2 into B12 minus here B21. Here rest part is B21. So this is the equation 5. This is taken as equation 5. According to Boltzmann distribution function, according to Boltzmann distribution function, we know that N2 by N1 is equal to this part, E epsilon H mu divided by K beta T. If we taking N1 by N2 is equal to E H mu divided by K beta T, in place of here, sign will be changed, minus means plus. So according to distribution Maxwell distribution function, we know that N1 by N2 is equal to E H mu divided by K beta T. K beta T, H is the Planck constant, mu is the frequency, K beta, Boltzmann constant, is the absolute temperature. This is coming from Boltzmann distribution function. Now, this value can be, means the value of N1 by N2 will be placed into this equation 5. The value of this N1 by N2 means this part, right hand side, value of this equation means right hand, the value of N1 by N2, which is given in right hand side of this equation, is placed in equation 5. In that case, we can write energy density is equal to here A21, in place of A21, we can write A21 divided by, here divided by N1 by N2 means E H mu divided by K beta T. Here I have written, and this B12 E H mu divided by K beta T minus, here rest part is B21. Then we are getting equation 6. Now, according to Planck's formula for energy density, here, energy density can be written as U mu. In every steps, we can write energy density as a U mu. So U mu is equal to, according to Planck's formula, energy density must be equal to 8 pi H mu Q divided by C Q into 1 by E H mu divided by K beta T. According to Planck's formula, energy density, equation of energy density is given here. In this equation, here H be the Planck constant, mu be the frequency, C is the velocity of light. This K beta is the Boltzmann constant, T is the absolute temperature. According to Planck's formula for energy density, must be equal to this one. Now, suppose this is equation 7. So, in both the equation 6 or 7, here I have not written 7. Suppose this is equation 7. So, in both these equations, means equation 6, in the left hand side of equation 6 and equation 7, both in both these equation energy density are given. So equating equation 6 and 7, after equating equation 6 and 7, we can write the value of equation C in the left direction, means A21 divided by B12 E H mu divided by K beta T minus B21. Is equal to this part, equation 7. In right hand side, we can write the value of equation 7, means 8 pi H mu Q divided by C Q divided by into 1 by E H mu divided by K beta T. So we can write A21 divided by B12 is equal to, here both the sides, E H mu divided by K beta T are given here. So rest part is A21 divided by B12 is equal to, again we can write A21 divided by this B21 is equal to 8 pi H mu Q divided by C Q. This part will cancel. So rest part is A21 divided by B12 is equal to, again A21 divided by B12. This A21 is always divided with these two parts, is equal to, here rest part is 8 pi H mu Q C Q. So here A21 divided by B12 is equal to A21 divided by B21. So in this case, A21 and A21 will be cancelled. So after that, we are getting B12 is equal to B21. This is the most important.
A21 किससे cancel हो?
Notes दिया हुआ देख लेना. हाँ बोलो. A21 divided by B12 is equal to this A21 divided by B12 is equal to 8 pi H mu Q divided by C Q. These parts are, after cancellation of this EH mu divided by K beta T, rest part is A21 divided by B12 minus B21 is equal to 8 pi H mu Q C Q. So we can write A21 divided by B12 is equal to A21 divided by B21 is equal to 8 pi H mu Q C Q. So A21 divided by B12. A21, here again we can write A21, both are cancelled. So rest part is B12 is equal to B21. Now again, I will repeat this calculation part of this Einstein's coefficient. Calculation part, only calculation part. Because I have already told two times the explanation part of Einstein's coefficient. According to this diagram, we can say that that atoms are moving from lower direction to upward direction. So in this case, absorption process will take place. Then the transition rate for absorption, we can write dN1 divided by dT absorption is equal to B12 energy density U mu N1. N1 means the number of atoms present in the lower energy level, and B21 is the is a constant energy density. U mu is the energy density. B12 can be written because atoms are moving from lower energy level 1 to upper energy level 2. That's why we can write here B12 for absorption process. Now, next, if the atoms move from upper direction to upper energy level to lower energy level, upper energy level is E2, energy level 2, and E1 be the energy level 1. So in that case, the transition rate from for stimulated emission is equal to B21, energy density U mu, N2. N2 be the number of atoms present in the upper energy level. Energy density can be written as U mu, and B21 means the atoms, initially the atoms are present in the upper energy level 2. So we can write first 2. After that, if the atom jumps from energy level 2 to 1, after time t, it reaches to the energy level 1. So in that case, we can write 1. Yeah. Now, next is, here, in according to this diagram, we can say that transition rate for spontaneous emission is equal to N2A21, and this must be independent of the energy density. That's why we cannot retain energy density in this equation 3. Now, all the transition rate, all the value of transition rate, spontaneous stimulated and spontaneous emission, we are getting. After that, according to this diagram, we can say that transition rate for absorption must be equal to the sum of spontaneous emission and stimulated emission. So B12, the value of absorption process is B12 energy density U mu N1 is equal to B21 energy density U mu N2 plus this N2 A21. So here both the values are, suppose energy density are present in these two parts, means in left direction is present or in right direction present. So here this value comes towards the left direction. So B12 energy density N1 is minus B21 energy density N2 is equal to N2 A21. After solving this equation, we can write this part. So yeah, energy density will be taken as a common, so that rest part is B12 N1 minus B21 N2 is equal to N2 A21. Energy density will be taken as a common. So energy density is equal to here N2 divided by A21. Divided by this part N1 B12 minus N2 B21. So we are getting equation 4. According to the population, remember my statement. According to the population inversion process, upper energy level is more populated than lower energy level. Higher population is required in the upper energy level for leisure action, higher population. So here in this diagram, N2 be the upper energy number of atoms present in the upper energy level is 2. So N2 upper energy number of atoms N2 be divided N2 be the divided in equation 4 of all parts. So energy density is equal to N2 divided by N2 A21 N1 divided by N2 B12 minus N2 divided by N2 B21. So in that case, N2 by N2 will be cancelled. So next so rest part is A21 divided by N1 by N2 B12 minus B21. According to Boltzmann distribution function, we know that this part N2 by N1 is equal to E minus H mu divided by K beta T. If we are taking N1 by N2, so in that case, we can write here negative sign will be changed to positive. So N1 by N2, this part can be written as here. N1 by N2 is equal to E H mu divided by K beta T. According to Boltzmann distribution function, we can find out the ratio between the number of atoms is equal to this part. Here H be the length constant, mu is the frequency, K beta is the Boltzmann constant, T is the absolute temperature. Now, equation 5 can be written as energy density is equal to this A21 divided by here B12 can be written here into the value of N1 and N2 is given here. So this value can be put in this position. So E H mu divided K beta T minus rest part in equation 5 is B21. So here we can write B21. Now we are getting equation 6. Now according to Planck's formula, we know that according to Planck's formula for energy density, here U mu be the energy density. So according to Planck's formula for energy density, we know that it must be equal to 8 pi h mu q divided by c q into 1 by h mu divided by k beta t. So this this is the equation, this equation is equation 7. So now in equation 6 or equation 7, in left hand side, energy density is given in left hand side. So equating equation 6 and 7, we get A21. This part we can see. So rest part is A21. First, we can write A21 B12 E H mu divided by K beta T minus B21 is equal to 8 pi H mu Q C Q into 1 by H mu divided by K beta T. So this part will cancel. Rest part is A21 divided by this B12 minus equal to this A21. Again, it is divided by B21 is equal to here rest part is 8 pi H mu Q divided by C Q. So A21 will be cancelled. So here we can write B12 is equal to B21. This Einstein's coefficient Einstein's coefficient are also explained in module 1, which is module 1 means in quantum physics. In quantum physics, introduction to quantum physics, I have already explained the Einstein's coefficient. And also the details about this Einstein's coefficient are given. Notes are also available for module 1. So according to today's class, there are several questions are arising or it may be asked by the university. First question will be arise, means what is the full form of laser? Next, what is the definition of laser? I have already given the notes for definition of pleasure. What are the properties or characteristics of pleasure? What is the difference between ordinary light and laser light? Ordinary light and laser light. In both the lights, there is a term. It means coherent and incoherent what are coming into both the light. So coherent means the photons are not in the same phase. Incoherent means the photons are not in the same phase, and coherent means photons are in the same phase. Photons are in the same phase means when we suppose we are standing in the admin block of Chaibasani in college and switch on the laser light. In that case, we can see that the photons covers an area of 10 centimeter, means 5 centimeter in left direction and 5 centimeter in right direction. Means the photons cover equal area in left or right direction at admin building of Chaibasani in college. If we go to and after some time it will see that in highway in place of road or senior boys hostel in place of senior boys hostel, we can see that laser light when it comes to senior boys hostel place in front of this senior boys hostel place, the laser light takes same area, means it covers five centimeter in left direction or 5 centimeter in right direction. It means the laser groups, the photons are in the same phase for laser light. Photons are